In the book of Galatians, chapter 1, verses 6 through 12, it reads as thus. It says, I marvel that you are so soon removed from him that called you into this grace of Christ unto another gospel, which is not another, but there be some that trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. Now, as we said before, and so I say now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that ye have received, let him be accursed. For do I now persuade men or God, or do I seek to please men? For if I yet please men, I should not be a servant of Christ. But I certify you, brethren, that the gospel which was preached of me is not after man. For I neither received it of man, neither was I taught it, but by the revelation of Jesus Christ. You can turn your Bibles to the 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. Chapter 2, verse 14. It says, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 14 says, Whereunto he called you by our gospel, to the obtaining of the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brethren, stand fast and hold the traditions which you have been taught, whether by word or epistle. Now our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God, even our Father, which have loved us, have given us everlasting consolation and good hope through grace. Comfort your hearts, and establish you in every good word and work. You can bow your heads now. Father, in the name of Jesus. Everybody wants to, and what I bring about with that is that people don't like opposition. People don't like when you say it's black or it's white. They don't like when you say you must be baptized in Jesus' name. They don't like when you say you must be filled with the Spirit. If you have not my Spirit, you are none of mine. People don't like when you stand on one side. Everybody's all right if you in the middle. But when you on one side, see, something about when you can run into somebody who is a person that is just straightforward. You'll say, I don't want to talk to her. She just only thinks one way. No, it's just black and white with that person. And the reason why folks don't like to deal with that person, they're going to get either a yay or a nay. Well, my Bible says that all the things that the Lord is yay and nay. Maybe they got that from the Lord. He don't have a middle ground. He doesn't have a purgatory. He doesn't have a place where you can kind of sit here until you get it together. It's either right or it's wrong. It's either you either a saint or you a sinner. You either going to heaven or you going to hell. There ain't no middle ground with him. And the minute that you put something out there in that way, the opposition comes your way. So Paul here in the book of Galatians, he's writing, he says, I marvel that you're so soon moved from the grace of called into, removed from him that calls you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel. And this is what I'm saying, the enemy is trying to put out another gospel. Anytime that you would put Christian on the back of something that you already know Christ is against, that's another gospel. It is trying to pervert the mind. He uses that word. He says, it's not another gospel, which is another, but there be some that trouble you, which would pervert the gospel of Christ. That was perversion. That is perversion. when it goes out, amen, and it doesn't, and why do we have to attack it? We have to attack it here in the house of God immediately, because why? You have kids sitting with you right now who the enemy, I said it in Sunday school, they're trying to use this word bully, that if you bully somebody, he is trying to pervert their minds that these things are okay, amen, and that these things are okay, and now they're asking you questions, and now if you can't stand there flat-footed and say, no, it's wrong, you in trouble with God. I noticed that through that Facebook post, I used apostolic. And we're living in a time, amen, some of you who are older than me that have come up through this church and other churches, I said, there's a lot that don't understand even what apostolic means. Even understand that when you say that you're dealing with the doctrine, when you deal with being apostolic, that you're dealing with the fact that I believe in something, amen, that was left or given to the apostles, which was the doctrine that Jesus told them to preach. So if I say I'm apostolic, I'm all right, because I say I'm Christian, amen. But the thing is, what's scary about saying I'm Christian, amen, puts me in a broader perspective with a whole lot of people. But then what makes me apostolic might put me in a situation that somebody said, I don't want to be known by them to be apostolic, because there was some teachers who went out and taught them about clothing and about music and about this and about not going to the movies and all the knots and all the things. So there's some now that I said, I don't want to be apostolic. When that part that's saying I don't want to be apostolic is not apostolic at all, because that's not the doctrine that they're talking about. They're talking about legalism, and it has nothing to do with the preaching and teaching of Jesus Christ and the death, burial, and resurrection of him, amen, who called you and I out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen. When we talk about being apostolic, that's why I read the other scripture, and I'll get to it. But this is what Paul is saying. Some of you are allowing things to pervert your mind. Some people are allowing people to say there ain't no love in the apostolic church. The love that they're talking, that they're saying it ain't in the church, is when we stand on one side and say it's black or it's white. It's not about it being apostolic. It's about it being right. It's either holiness or hell. That's what apostolic has been about. It's about holiness. And Jesus said, be ye holy, for I am holy. So you got to understand, amen, you don't need to be ashamed, hallelujah, amen, of being apostolic. You might need to be ashamed of being very too much legalistic in your view, amen. But when you're following Christ, amen, I want to say today, amen, if I can tell my pastor who taught me as I grew up, now I understand that when I follow Christ, I'm following the chief apostle. He's apostolic. Yeah, when I follow Jesus, amen, you don't want to be apostolic, amen, that's on you. I'm going to be apostolic because Jesus was apostolic, amen. That's why he said, amen. But though, amen, when you look at Galatians 1 and 8, amen. Yeah, I'm going to need some help. I feel like preaching. He said, but you look at Galatians 1 and 8. He said, but though we or an angel preach any other gospel, amen. What is another gospel? Amen. This other junk that's going on out here. This other junk that's saying, amen. Oh, you Christian, amen. Y'all don't have no love. Y'all tell somebody if they ain't baptized in Jesus' name, they ain't saved, amen. All I'm trying to tell you is what the Bible said. The Bible said they went down in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm not trying to tell you any other thing. Why? He said, if I preach any other gospel than that which was preached, he said, count it a curse, amen. If I tell you, amen, I'm not going to let you go, hallelujah, to hell without the Holy. I'm not going to let you go to hell because I didn't tell you you need the Holy Ghost, amen. Amen. Somebody told me that what we need to do is be able to be proud to be apostolic. Amen. I didn't tell you what my topic is, but that's my topic. Amen. He said, stand fast in Thessalonians. And the subtopic is why I'm proud to be apostolic. You ought to be proud. Hallelujah. Don't no Mormon ride the bike in all his heat if he ain't proud to be Mormon. Ain't no Jehovah Witness standing in front of all them Jonah shops if they ain't proud to be Jehovah Witness. Ain't no Muslim doing what they doing if they ain't proud to be Muslim. And what's wrong with you if you can't stand up and be proud to be apostolic? You ought to be proud. Hallelujah. Oh, I might I sound mad, I ain't mad. I'm upset with the devil. I'm mad with folk who don't want to stand. See, let me tell you how God confirmed my message. I'm going to get to the scripture. I went in the office to print out my message. And when I got this book, Brother Marcus, this book, it says it's the Christian Outlook. It's from the organization. And on the cover of it, it says the loving memory of our sainted bishops. And it's got in here all the bishops who have died over the last 12 years. And it made me think. I said, thank you, Lord. You're giving me the right mind to think about what I'm about to preach. And I said, thank you. Why? Because there's men and women. I looked up the word martyr, and I'll get to it, and I start thinking about this thing. There are men, and I think about when I saw you sitting here. I know it's Mother's Day, and it can be very emotional because your mother went on to be with the Lord. But that's something to give God the glory for. She went on to be with the Lord. And there's so many men and women that have went down and have died. They have died for the apostolic doctrine. They have died for the name of Jesus. They have been pulled apart. The Bible says there's some time that some men been thrown, amen, in the lion's den, amen. Not Daniel, they were thrown in and to be eaten, amen, because they believed in the testimony and they preached apostolic doctrine. They were pulled asunder. The Bible said there was things, amen, hallelujah, in Fox's Book of Martyrs. He talks about, amen, how the people were pulled apart, how people were set on fire, how people was put in places. And I'm going to get over to 2012 because President Obama and a couple of disgruntled, supposed to be apostolic folk is mad at the church, and I'm not going to be proud that God came down, sent a woman to do my aunt's hair. I didn't know nothing about this thing. See, sometimes you got to think things over. As the song says, when I look back over my life, I think things over, and man, I can truly say I'm a testimony. That's why we ought to come in here every Sunday. Shouldn't nobody even have to stand up and you give God the glory. Why? Somebody, my Aunt Paula, who went on to be with the Lord, she was getting her hair done, and a sister named Yvette Water started preaching to her, started telling her, amen. And I didn't know that some way, hallelujah, through that God was going to bring me to a little old raggedy church on Prairie, where God was preaching the gospel, where the man of God was preaching the gospel, and he said to me one day, who wants to be saved? I thank the Lord that somebody brought me to an apostolic Pentecostal church. Oh, you ought to be excited that God brought you by and he gave you the word of God. Somebody ought to be excited. You were right. Jesus' name.